Students, next we discuss about energy, power and intensity of a wave. Energy, power and intensity of a wave. This is for objective topic, not IPE topic. It is an objective topic. So, we know that the wave will be traveling, the displacement of the wave, y equal to A sin omega t minus kx. A sin omega t minus kx. This is the formula of displacement of a wave or progressive wave or traveling any wave. Okay. So, first of all, we find the energy. Energy is nothing but kinetic energy, and because of wave will always in motion, so it's having kinetic energy. So this kinetic energy per unit volume is called energy density. Okay, so first we find the energy density, and after we find the energy, and the next power and the next intensity of a wave. So first of all, we find the kinetic energy. So kinetic energy is the half mv square. So v is the velocity. So we have to find the velocity of the wave. So the velocity of the wave v equal to, you know that the rate of change of displacement. That is, it will be differentiated with respect to t. T is y is differentiated with respect to t. That is d by dt of a sin omega t minus kx. Omega t minus kx. Okay, so v equal to d by dt of a constant sin x, nothing but cos x, that is omega t minus kx. Okay, and t term will be omega, so we can write omega. That is, velocity v equal to a omega cos omega t minus kx. This is the second dimension. So, displacement of wave and velocity of wave, we will find. Next, we find the energy of a given wave. Energy of a given wave. So, energy, think about the energy density. Energy density. Energy density U equal to delta E by delta T. Sorry, not T. It is V because of density. Delta E by delta V. So, this energy is nothing but kinetic energy. Then delta K E or by delta V. So, delta K is the kinetic energy. It's nothing but half delta M V square by delta V. Delta M by delta V. That is, mass per unit volume is density or mass density. That is, U equal to half rho V square because of rho equal to mass per unit volume or delta M by delta V. Okay. So, this U equal to half rho V square. V is the formula. V square. That is A omega and cos omega T minus Kx. This is the V square. Whole square. So, U equal to half rho A square omega square cos omega T minus Kx square. Okay, so this is for energy density formula. But when is energy becomes maximum? When is energy becomes maximum? If energy is maximum, then this term omega T minus Kx is becomes zero. Okay, it will be 0, then cos 0 equal to 1, then energy. Find the energy, half rho A square omega square. Okay. Next, we can find power. Second one is power. You know that power P equal to energy by time. Energy by time. That is the rate of transmission. The rate of transmission. And in this, we have to find only energy density, U. But we find energy. So, this energy delta E equal to U into delta V. Okay? So, but U equal to half rho A square omega square. U becomes delta E by delta V half rho A square omega square. Delta E equal to half rho A square omega square delta V. Delta V, V is the value. Value means area into length. Area is nothing but we consider as S in this area. S is a area. And length, nothing but position, dx. Okay? So delta V is the area into position or length. Therefore, delta E equal to half rho A square omega square and S into delta X. This is the equation number 5. Okay? So, we have to find power. Therefore, power P equal to delta E by delta T, which is equal to delta E half rho A square omega square S delta X by delta T. That is delta X by delta T. Distance by time or length by time. What is length by time? It is nothing but velocity. So, we have to write half rho velocity v A square omega square. This is the power form. This is the sixth equation. It is the sixth equation. Next. And third one. What is third one? Intensity of a given wave. So, intensity of a wave. Intensity I is defined as power per unit area. Power per unit area. So, power half rho V A square and omega square, we miss the term S. So, S by P by S. P by S. S, S will get cancelled. I is equal to half rho V A square omega square. This is the intensity formula. So, by using this formula, we concluded that I is proportional to A square. I is proportional to A square if all terms are remains constant. So, this is very important formula. Intensity of any wave is directly proportional to amplitude square. For example, we can take a wave. Okay? So, we can take a wave. This is the wave. One wave. What is its amplitude? Its amplitude is one. And its intensity is I1. And this amplitude is A1. Okay? So, in this situation, we have to increase this amplitude. Then what happens? This amplitude will be A2 and intensity will be I2. If A2 is greater than A1, then I2 is also greater than I1 by using I is proportional to A square. Okay? So, a wave intensity, a wave power, a wave energy will be increases, then we must and should increase their amplitude. For example, I am speaking very slowly. Say, wave is said very slowly. Wave. Okay? Wave, 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 wave. So, slowly my voice, that is sound, that is amplitude of sound wave will be increases. Then what happened? Energy of wave is also increased, power of wave is also increased, and intensity of sound wave is also be increased. So, it mainly depends on its amplitude, our device amplitude. Okay?